afternoon, everyone. My name is Judy Walker, and I'm honored to be here on this beautiful day with no smoke, wind, rain, just sunshine, to perform the marriage of Maureen and Andrew today. It has been a pleasure to meet them and get to know a bit about their love story and the journey that brought them to this place in their lives today, where with a few traditional words and rites, they will become husband and wife. You are here because in some way you're an important part of Andrew and Maureen's lives, and they wanted you here to witness and celebrate their devotion, respect, and love for each other as they are united in marriage. This ceremony is a public affirmation of that love, and as their dearest family and friends, it is your honor and your privilege to stand witness to this event. Maureen and Andrew are grateful for your presence, and I welcome you on their behalf. During these uncertain days in which we live, where original wedding plans have to be changed to meet the medical protocols under which we all live, it is even more special that you have been asked to be here. They must really like you. So family photos are planned immediately after the ceremony, and refreshments are waiting in the tent for the rest of the guests. I ask that you turn off your cell phones, and by request of the bride and groom, that no pictures are taken during the ceremony. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, will you please rise to greet the bride?
Thank you.
Please be seated. Okay. Maureen and Andrew, welcome to this, your wedding day. After 3 years together, you are standing here after facing the trials and tribulations of planning this wedding again and again and again. Besides that challenge, you were both laid off from your jobs, had time to face the stressors that came with quarantine and being together all the time for months on end. But yet here you are. Here you are standing in front of your closest family and friends where you will finally become husband and wife, and your lives will change forever. Because after today, you will be able to say something you have never been able to say before. You will be able to say, "This is my husband and this is my wife." Maureen, you have had to be especially patient in this relationship and getting to this point today, besides having to replan your wedding. When you worked together, you developed a crush on this hardworking, helpful, funny, kind man. All of that, and he's kind of cute. But unfortunately, you had to wait until he was free to be pursued, and then pursue him you did. In fact, when you finally got together at that bar for drinks after work, Andrew wasn't even sure it was a real date because you had been work friends for so long. And you really couldn't believe that this beautiful, smart woman would really want to go out with you, Andrew. But once you figured out that she really liked you, your relationship developed. And as you both said so correctly, after that, your relationship moved forward like a boulder rolling downhill. You moved in together, worked together, went backpacking, and learned to enjoy the other's interests, be it hiking or mountain biking. And though you have been challenged in the planning of this wedding, the engagement itself was perfect. That romantic event that it should have been, on a moonlit beach on Maureen's favorite place, Thunder Beach in Ontario. You have built a strong base for your marriage with all the good times you have had together, as well as facing the challenges of the last 6 months. Today, though, everything changes. Today, you are announcing to each other and the world that you are formally taking into your care and trust the happiness of the one person in the world whom you love with all your heart, each other. You are agreeing to share life's deepest and richest experiences. You are adding to your life not only the affection of each other, but also the companionship and the blessing of mutual respect. You have invited these guests, all the real special people in your lives, to share the celebration of your love, a love that now culminates in your union as husband and wife. When you enter into marriage, you enter into life's most important relationship. It is a gift, given to comfort where there is sorrow, peace when there is unrest, laughter when there is happiness, and love when it is shared. Real love goes far beyond the feelings of romance and bliss. It is caring more about the well-being and happiness of your marriage partner than your own needs and desires. Love in marriage makes burdens lighter because you divide them. It makes joys more intense because you share them. It makes you stronger so you can become involved with life in ways you dare not risk alone. Real love says you are stronger together than you ever were apart. A successful marriage is not something that just happens. It takes work and it takes effort. More importantly, it takes a commitment from both of you. A good marriage must be created and nurtured so it can continue to grow on the sound foundation that you have built over the past 3 years. And if cracks form, you have to continue to use what you have learned and the joys and the adversities you have faced together to glue those cracks back together. And the best glue is love. Love and patience and laughter and commitment. And so it is with this understanding that Maureen and Andrew present themselves to be married today. I now call upon you both in the presence of these witnesses to repeat after me.
Mm-hmm.
I do solemnly declare
that I do not know
of any lawful impediment
why I, Maureen Frances Hill,
may not be joined in matrimony to Andrew Frederick Penny Pike.
I do solemnly declare that I do not know of any lawful impediment why I, Andrew Frederick Penny Pike, may not be joined in matrimony to Maureen Frances Hill.
That was very good. As no impediment was declared or admitted, I require you to affirm your intent. Do you, Maureen, promise to give to Andrew your mindful presence, your understanding, and your constant love? Do you promise to stand by and love him through joy and sorrow, sickness and health, and stand with him through all that life brings to you both?
I do.
And do you, Andrew, promise to give to Maureen your mindful presence, your understanding, and your constant love? Do you promise to stand by and love her through joy and sorrow, sickness and health, and stand with her through all that life brings to you both?
I do.
I would now like to call on Josh, Nate, Sophia, and Maria to share with the couple a reading from 1 Corinthians, but we welcome Sophia and Maria to come forward.
A reading from Paul to the Corinthians. If I speak in tongues of men or of angels, but I do not have love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and give over my body to hardship, that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing.
Love is always patient and kind, is never jealous. Love is never boastful or conceited. It is never rude or selfish. It does not take offense and is not resentful.
Love takes no pleasure in other people's wrongs, but delights the truth. It is always ready to excuse, to trust, to hope, and to ensure whatever comes.
It's possible.
Maureen and Andrew, the promises that you are about to make with each other are a meaningful and sacred expression of your love for each other. As you commit your lives to each other with the vows that you are about to share, may you do so in all seriousness, but also with a deep sense of joy, with the understanding and the deep conviction that you are committing yourselves to an ever-growing relationship of trust, mutual support, and caring love.
I call upon those persons present to witness that I, Maureen Frances Hill, do take you, Andrew Frederick Penny Pike, to be my lawful wedded husband. I, Maureen, take you, Andrew, to be my husband, my constant friend, my faithful partner, and my love from this day forward. In the presence of our family and friends, I offer you my solemn vow to be your partner in sickness and in health, in good times and in bad, and in joy as well as in sorrow. I promise to love you unconditionally, to support you in your goals, to honor and respect you, to laugh with you and cry with you, and to cherish you. I give you my hand, my heart, and my love for as long as we both shall live.
So, Andrew.
I call upon those persons present to witness that I, Andrew Frederick Penny Pike, do take you, Maureen Frances Hill, to be my lawful wedded wife. I, Andrew, take you, Maureen, to be my wife, my constant friend, my faithful partner, and my love from this day forward. In the presence of our family and friends, I offer you my solemn vow, to be your partner in sickness and in health, in good times and in bad, and in joy as well as in sorrow. I promise to love you unconditionally, to support you in your goals, to honor and respect you, to laugh with you, to cry with you, and to cherish you. I give you my hand, my heart, and my love for as long as we both shall live.
Since the beginning of time, the ring has been an emblem of the sincerity and the permanence of a couple's love for one another and regard for their marriage. The rings that you have chosen to share today are a symbol and a reminder of the vows you have shared today. May these rings be your most treasured adornment, and may the love they symbolize be your most precious possession. Having declared her marriage vows, let Maureen place the ring on the third finger of Andrew's left hand.
Andrew, I choose you of all others to be my husband. I offer this ring as a token of our love. And with it, I join my life to yours.
And having declared his marriage vows, let Andrew place the ring on the third finger of Maureen's left hand.
Maureen, I choose you above all others to be my wife. I offer this ring as a token of our love. And with it, I join my life to yours.
We now welcome Maureen's brother Brian to come forward and share a reading from Winnie the Pooh, who we know is Maureen's favorite character.
Okay. If ever there is tomorrow when we're not together, there is something you must always remember. You are braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, and smarter than you think. But the most important thing is, even if we are apart, I'll always be with you.
Maureen and Andrew, may your partnership stay sweet and filled with everyday graces. May your home be a sanctuary, vibrant with love, passion, and beauty. May your marriage be blessed with the love of family and good friends. May you together experience good fortune, both material and spiritual. May your marriage be your greatest blessing and your highest achievement. May you laugh together in joy, grieve together in sorrow, and may you grow old together in love. And may you always be thankful for the love you share today and always, for remember that it is love that brought you here today, and it is through love by which your marriage will endure. Maureen and Andrew, you have consented in marriage, and you have declared your solemn intention in this company, before these witnesses, and in my presence. You have exchanged these rings as a pledge of your love to one another, and you have joined your hands to accept one another. And now, upon the authority vested in me by the province of Alberta, I pronounce you husband and wife, and you may seal the promises you made today with a kiss. This is great.
Yeah, finally.
All right, let's go. Let's go over here and take care of this paperwork. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm proud and honored to be the first to be able to introduce to you as a husband and wife, Andrew and Maureen Pike.
so much for watching.
Hi.
We appreciate it so much, and obviously we wish she could have been here, but we got married and we're pretty excited about it. So.
Yeah, we're so happy that we're able to stream it so people can watch.
Yeah.
So thank you
thank
for
you
tuning
so much.
In.
We love you.
That's kind of weird to say. Thanks.
Thank you so much,
that
Kevin.
Great.
That was really good.
That was great. Thank you.
Okay.